Best in Year for Yongmin Park, Gold for Nuri Han, Best in Year Nuri Han, and Best in School Nuri Han. I'll wait for them to appear and then we'll give them a round of applause. Right, you can start clapping now. Good. Let's give Nuri a round of applause, best in school. I'll make sure Harry gets his certificate. Marvellous, Ryan, we're good to go. Thank you very much. We're on to our last moral virtue. In my little jaunt through some moral virtues for this term. And we've reached now the final virtue in this list as identified by the Jubilee Centre for Character Education at the University of Birmingham. And the final virtue that they identify is respect. Having due regard for someone else's feelings and rights. The importance of respect. Respecting other people. One of the things that I think it's really important for every single one of us to remember is that respect is a two-way street. In other words, you have to give respect in order to earn respect. I have, in the past, heard various statements made by pupils and members of staff along the lines of, yeah, well, he or she doesn't respect me. They were dissing me, they were disrespecting me. Well, do you show respect? Because if you don't show respect to others, why on earth should you expect to receive respect from others? There's nothing about you that means you should deserve respect. There's nothing special about you that means you should deserve respect more than anybody else. There's nothing special about me that means I should deserve respect more than anybody else. It is very much a two-way street. I give respect, I earn respect. It is a mutual relationship. I'd like to just take a few moments today to whiz through five very quick, very practical suggestions as to how we as a family here at Kingsley, we as a school, might be able to show respect to other people. So here we go. For what they're worth, here are the five suggestions I want to make to you today. Number one, listen to people. When you listen to somebody, look them in the eye. Put your phone down. Focus on them. And if it's a conversation whereby some kind of feedback is required, they're asking your opinion, they want to know what you think about something, share it. Tell them what you think. But listening is important, isn't it? I'm sure most of you will have heard this said many, many times before. But we have two ears and one mouth, and there's a good reason for that. It's more important to listen than it is perhaps to tell everybody what we think all the time. So can I encourage us to listen to each other? Because it is a sign of respect that you listen to what other people are saying. The second thing is just to encourage. We've all had those moments, haven't we? Every single person in this room has had those moments where we just need someone to come alongside us and go, do you know what? Don't worry. It will be okay. I know you're having a tough time right now, but it will be okay. And we all of us need friends and colleagues who will draw alongside us and encourage us. Because life isn't always easy, is it? Life can be very, very stressful. It can be very, very difficult. It can be very demanding. Bad things happen to the very, very best of people. So it's important to encourage other people. It might not seem like much to you, but the impact it has on the person whom you are encouraging is inestimable. They will be very grateful to have been encouraged by you. Third thing I'd like to suggest that we should be doing, we should be congratulating one another. We've just done it this morning. Congratulating those who've worked really, really hard at the UK Maths Challenge. Congratulating those who've worked really, really hard at their basketball. We should congratulate people. If someone does a good job, tell them they've done a good job. Encourage them and congratulate them. It's one of the things that I think is the most important thing we can do in a collective environment like an assembly, is congratulate members of our community on the excellent things that they've done. And it's really important that we are publicly congratulating one another and also privately congratulating one another. When was the last time you said well done to one of your friends because they had done something successful or something impressive? Take the time to congratulate them. Fourth way I think we can show respect is by helping others. This doesn't necessarily mean, hey, give me all your homework, I'll do it for you. That's actually not helping them. But when you see somebody struggling, do you help? Do you offer to help? Small daily acts of kindness directed at your friends, directed at those in the school. Really simple, practical things that you and I can do to help and support one another. Please can I encourage us all to be as helpful as we possibly can. And the last one, I think we've said it already this term, but I think it's really, really important. Say thank you. We had a wonderful assembly a few weeks ago about gratitude and the importance of being grateful. So say thank you. It is common sense, isn't it? But it's very easy to forget to say thank you. Thank you to your friends. Thank you to your family. Thank you to your parents. Thank you to your teachers. Thank you to your colleagues. Two very, very simple words, but they do mean a lot when we say them. We know how we feel when people thank us for doing things. It makes you feel good. It gives you a little bit of a lift. Now squeeze all those five together, and I think we're getting close to what it perhaps means to respect other people. To have respect for their views, to have respect for their rights. We're not going to agree with them all the time. We don't have to. But we can still respect them in the way we treat them, the way we speak to them, the way we speak about them when they're not there. All of these things are marks of our respect. I'm going to sum it all up with a very, very simple verse which I shared with you earlier in the term. Some of you may remember it. It's a verse that comes from the New Testament in Philippians, and it says, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves. In other words, don't do things just because you think everyone will think I'm wonderful if I do these things. Everyone will think I'm amazing. I'm the best. That's not what we should be doing. Value others above yourself. Look around you. Keep your eyes and ears open. Who's having a tough time at the moment? In your tutor group, in your year group. Who's struggling? You might not know the full story. You might not know what's going on at home. You might not know the friendship issues that are happening in school. But you can help. You can show respect. And you can do the five things that are up on the screen there to prompt us. You can listen to them. You can encourage them. You can congratulate them when things go well. You can help them when they're struggling. And you can say thank you. So as we draw to the end of this year, looking at virtues, the moral virtues, the things that make your character and my character, I hope some of them have stuck. I hope at some point through the term, there's been at least one thing which has kind of struck a chord in your mind. And you thought, yeah, I'm not very good at that. And actually, I could do that a little bit better. I could be kinder. I could be more respectful. I could show more gratitude. So as we come to the end of what has been a very long, very tiring term, please can I just encourage us in the last 10 days of term to be respectful of each other, all of us, myself included. Let's be respectful of each other. Some of you, I realise, are on your knees. You are literally, physically exhausted. I would just like to commend those of you in the line, the witch, and the wardrobe. I know how hard you've been working. I know how many hours and hours you've sacrificed to work on that production, how many weekends you've given up for rehearsals while the rest of us have been sitting at home. You have been in here, you have been practicing hour after hour after hour. Well done. And as they say in the theatre world, break a leg, a week to go. Support one another, encourage one another as a cast. I'm really looking forward to it. I'll be coming to both of the evening performances. I'm very, very much looking forward to it. And I hope the rest of you will come and support your peers in that play next Monday and next Tuesday evening. We'll just stop, ask you to sit quietly for a moment. Just reflect on the screen that's up there. And I'll end shortly. Heavenly Father, I pray that you'll help us not to do anything out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. That you will help us in humility to value others above ourselves. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.